Thank you for choosing 900 CHML, a Chorus Entertainment radio station. Listen anywhere on the Radio Player Canada app.
Broadcasting live from the heart of Hamilton and streaming live to the world at 900CHML.com. This is Global News Radio 900CHML.
It's 9 o'clock. Good morning, I'm Paul Tipple. Lots of sunshine through the day as we reach a high of 28. Right now, it is 21. Sounds like the cost for sanctioned encampment sites won't be as high as $33 million, as presented in an interim report to city councillors this week. One of the staffers behind the report is describing it as a top model for operating those kinds of sites, where things like three full meals a day and all wraparound services are paid for by taxpayers. Danielle Blake tells CHML she's hoping people will wait to see what the next report, September 18th, will look like.
That will be a much more detailed and fulsome analysis of the plan for the sanctioned sites for Hamilton. And we plan to present different models, different operating models, and hopefully we can come up with some figures that maybe aren't quite that $33 million mark.
Blake says many of the services will be provided by community partners that were not included in this interim report. Some good news about the $290 million privately funded renovation of Hamilton's First Ontario Centre. As CHML's Ken Mann tells us, it's on schedule and on budget.
According to a presentation to city politicians by the Hamilton Urban Precinct Entertainment Group, demolition is underway and it is targeting November 2025 for reopening. Oakview Group's Tom Pastore, without naming him directly, has hinted that Shea Gilgeous-Alexander may be the project's latest investor.
We have a Canadian basketball star, potential MVP in NBA, and just came back from the Olympics. I'll let you glean on who that might be, but once we get him officially in the stack as a Hamiltonian, he is absolutely excited to be part of the project.
The story says they're already moving to book major events for late 2025 and into 2026, adding that the revived First Ontario Centre will serve as a relief valve for venues in Toronto. Ken Mann, 900CHML News.
The Ministry of Labour is investigating the death of a construction worker in Toronto. Fire Service Chief John Davidson says he was buried when a trench caved in on him late yesterday afternoon.
Upon arrival, Toronto Fire Services observed a worker in an unprotected trench and began extrication activities to free the worker. After approximately 50 minutes of activity, they were able to free the worker, then transport to Toronto Paramedic Services, who began medical treatment, and then transport to hospital.
He died a short time later. The circumstances that led to the incident are unknown. It is the second trench rescue in Toronto in the last month. A recent report by a UN official who visited Canada last year says our temporary worker program is a breeding ground for contemporary slavery. He said it a year ago, and this week doubled down on the comments in the form of a report.
In Special Rapporteur Tomoya Obokata's report for the UN, a power imbalance is described in Canada with temporary foreign workers unable to exercise their rights. Tomoya says a worker's status is dependent on a closed work permit and that is specific to their employer, and if they're fired, they may be deported. The report goes on to say workers are subject to a wide range of abuses and not always aware of what rights they do have. Abuses are outlined as well: wage theft, long working hours, no proper protective equipment, along with sexual exploitation and physical and verbal abuse. The report calls for Canada to end current labor immigration arrangements that tie workers to their employers and offer no path to permanent residency. Vladimir Matic, Global News.
The mayor of fire-ravaged Jasper, Alberta, is urging local residents to fill out a survey on the town's website to give officials a better idea of how many people need temporary housing once they return to Jasper this weekend. The actual housing units lost in last month's fire totaled 800. CHML News Time 904. Traffic and weather next.
At the David Braley Sport Medicine and Rehabilitation Center.
At sahamiltoncfs.ca.
Now with CHML traffic, here is Miles Marcus.
We just had a crash clear away from the Niagara-bound QEW past the junction, but you still see some lingering delays from Bronte to this problem, where it was at least. The Toronto-bound side is slow over the Burlington Skyway right through the North Shore, then some on-and-off delays from Guelph Line to 3rd Line. More of it on the eastbound 403 from Wilson on and off to Main, then toward 6 North. You'll find some delays there. Westbound Link also heavy from Upper Wentworth onto the eastbound 403. Charge ahead with the all-electric Chevrolet Equinox EV, a vehicle you know, value you'd expect, and a dealer right down the street. Ready to go EV? Chevrolet's got you. I'm Miles Marcus, 900 CHML traffic continues.
From the 900 CHML Weather Center, short and sweet today. Sunshine, a high of 28, clear tonight with more sun tomorrow, high 27. Right now it's 21. I'm Paul Tipple. News next at 9:30 on Global News Radio, 900 CHML.
Broadcasting live from the heart of Hamilton and streaming live to the world at 900CHML.com. This is Global News Radio, 900 CHML.
It's 9:30. Good morning, I'm Paul Tipple, one of the city staffers who presented an interim report this week on the cost of setting up sanctioned encampment sites, says there's plenty of room to lower the $33 million price tag. The city's Daniel Blake telling CHML they presented the maximum amount that would be needed, describing it as the top model with three full meals a day and all wraparound services paid for by taxpayers. Blake says the next report will be a more detailed analysis with different operating models that will include services provided by community partners.
We have a huge number of outreach teams that are out there doing really excellent work all day, every day. What can we do to bring those services together and to coordinate that to help support a sanctioned site or a tiny homes community as well? Are there community organizations that would be willing to donate, services or meals or things like that? So those are conversations we're going to be having with partners and the community over the next couple of weeks.
She says it means the next report will have a lower price tag. It'll be presented to councillors on September 18th. Meantime, a group representing Ontario municipalities is asking the province for guidance on how to handle homeless encampments. The Association of Municipalities of Ontario says there were at least 1,400 encampments across the province last year. The association says municipalities didn't create the homelessness crisis, but are being forced to manage it without the resources to do so properly. Closing arguments set to resume today at the criminal trial of two organizers of the Freedom Convoy. Tamara Leach and Chris Barber are on trial for their roles in launching the demonstrations that seized downtown Ottawa for nearly 3 weeks in early 2022. Now with CHML traffic, here's Miles Marcus.
Now with a problem-free drive, you'll find some volume still left on the drawbound QEW from the Wright Hill and over the Skyway to North Shore. There's some on-and-off delays from Guelph Line to 3rd Line. Going Niagara-bound, it slows down from Ford Drive to Trafalgar. Still some lingering volume on the eastbound 403 from Wilson to Main. A bit of slow drive on the westbound link as you approach the 403 as well. Royal Botanical Garden's spectacular rose collection is in bloom until end of August. Plan your visit today at rbg.ca. I'm Miles Marcus, 900 CHML traffic continues.
From the 900 CHML Weather Center, we'll have the sunshine through the remainder of the day, a high of 28, and a little sticky this afternoon, a humidex around 33. Clear skies tonight with a low of 13. Tomorrow, sunny and a high of 27. Right now, it's 22. I'm Paul Tipple. News next at 10 on Global News Radio, 900 CHML.
Choosing 900 CHML. Listen anytime on your smart speaker by asking for 900 CHML.
Broadcasting live from the heart of Hamilton and streaming live to the world at 900CHML.com. This is Global News Radio, 900 CHML.
Now is the perfect time to begin planning your financial future.
From G.ca. to The Alex Pearson Show on Hamilton's News Today's Talk.
900 CHML. And a proud Canadian. The only thing Roy Green is more devoted to is you. Consider Roy your personal advocate. Roy Green is never afraid to speak his mind. The Roy Green Show, sponsored by SealTech Flat Roofing, Saturday and Sunday afternoons from 2 until 5 on 900 CHML.
Now at Dofresh.
Hungry, you can give our students what they need to succeed. Consider hosting a back-to-school drive to collect school supplies or visit mission-services.com to donate meals. Mission Services. Act justly, show compassion, offer hope.
Loose frequencies, 900 on the AM dial. The call letters, CHML. We are 900 CHML. Listen anywhere you go on the iHeartRadio app.
We have some important news to share with you. Today, after decades of serving the great city of Hamilton, we want to inform you that we will be closing 900 CHML. We want to express our gratitude to each and every one of you in the community, and most importantly, our advertisers and our listeners. You are the cornerstone of our station's legacy. Thank you.